Elimination winner-take-all $1 million tournament. Game one of what's a quadruple header today. It's the 23, heard that, against the 10, the Peoria All-Stars. And what's a busy day as we hand out four more bids into the round of 16. We start with this one, and then Team Hines, Sideline Cancer, a couple of TBT veterans, Heartfire, and Men of Mackey, the Purdue alumni, and Armored Athlete and Power of the Paw finish it up. And we welcome you into the TBT Broadcast Center, everybody. Matt Martucci, a socially distanced Tim Scarborough with his quarantine cut. That's day two of the quarantine cut, right? And sideline reporter Jen Hale will be with us in just a little bit. Four bids handed out yesterday, Scar. We hand out four more today. Simply put, it was just great to have basketball back on a live stage and in 197 countries across the world. How about that?
That is great. And you know, we got off to a great start yesterday. Of course, that first game was a little choppy, but, you know, as the day wore on, the games got a little bit better and better, and it was capped off with a terrific finish at the end of game four. I suspect today will be just as good, if not, it's better than yesterday.
Yeah, Big X was part of that slow start. Michigan State alumnus Nick Ward with a big second half propelled them, and then it was the Philly backcourt, the Temple guys, led by Khalif Wyatt.
Khalif Wyatt with a splash, Elam Ender right there. Pack your bags, go home.
And Mike Dom leading House of Pain to what was a blowout victory over the mostly Auburn alumni, Ward Tampa, and finished it out in the nightcap. If your name was CJ, you had a good day yesterday.
Yeah, 50% of the guys who did Elam Enders were named CJ.
And today we end up handing out what is four more bids. And it is, of course, the 10-seed Peoria All-Stars, one of the youngest teams in TBT, may actually be the youngest against a veteran Marshall alumni team in Heard That, Scar, with plenty of guys that you and I are familiar with.
Yeah, of course, that Marshall team is coached by Dan D'Antoni, and he turned John Elmore loose. And you look at the times he was Conference USA first team. That is saying something. 2017-2019, career leader in Conference USA. Nobody scored more points than that young man right there, 2,638. We got to see a lot of those over the years.
And he's part of our star player profile brought to you by FanDuel. Enter Fantasy TBT contests. Compete for real cash payouts all tournament long. Well, on one side, a guy who could fill it up, and another one for the Peoria All-Stars, Trayvon Allen, a guy who played his college basketball at Idaho.
Yeah, he was an Idaho star, 21.6 points a game this past season. Didn't get to finish that season, of course, as no one did in college. But, you know, he has a chance to now kind of reignite his career after a few months. So, you know, he wants to pick up where he left off. 1,395 career points, 40% from downtown.
And looking to put that on display today. A fully quarantined, winner-take-all, $1 million tournament out in Columbus. And the word embedded comes to mind when you think of the third member of our team, our sideline reporter, Jen Hale, who's been part of a week-long and hardcore COVID-19 testing protocol.
Indeed, Matt, it has been hardcore. This Ohio bubble is no joke. The protocol is extremely strict. TBT brought in experts from Johns Hopkins to help them establish a best practices routine. And we have all had to follow it very strictly, including the Peoria All-Stars. They are an alternate team. Originally, they were not slated to play, but as an alternate team, they had to test at home. They had to show up 5 days early. They had to do the full quarantine to be eligible to play just in case. And indeed, TBT ended up having to send four teams home because of positive COVID tests. So the Peoria All-Stars are here today. But when you say hardcore, indeed, no one has been able to leave the hotel except to come to the arena once games started being played. The hotel, it is all TBT. In fact, TBT has even turned the ballrooms into practice courts. So when I say for 5 days no one left, I really mean it. Meals delivered into the hotel, nobody in or out without a credential. Plus, every player you see here, every person you see here, has had to pass five COVID tests with negative results in order to be allowed to stay. So certainly, TBT has put safety as the top priority, and the world's watching. I've been hearing from a lot of other executives in other sporting leagues who are taking note. How does this bubble work? What are the successes of it? This is getting a lot of eyeballs, guys. I assure you that.
Yeah, our seventh season at TBT. The prize money down to $1 million this year, 64 teams to 24, and a fully quarantined tournament here at Columbus with those extensive safety measures as Jen just went through. And we heard about the audiences that we, in fact, have, Tim Scarborough. One of the best stories I heard yesterday, some of our servicemen and women watching from an aircraft carrier.
How about that? On July 4th, very significant. Able to play basketball during that time is really a special thing, considering what we're going through worldwide in a pandemic.
Heard that in the green, and the Peoria All-Stars in the yellow.
Stole the tip.
And wasted no time. And this is their style, and there's on Elmore right out of the gate.
Well, we featured John Elmore, but it's the older brother, Ott, who gets it going from downtown.
Our starting lineup's brought to you by Air Force Reserve. Explore your opportunities with Air Force Reserve. Lukeman Lundy, one of the guys to highlight, a Bradley alum who ended up playing against Michigan State in the NCAA tournament. Aaron Menzies, 7'3" in the middle of that Peoria lineup.
Yeah, Ryan Taylor, 25 for Heard, that is just 6'7", so we'll watch that mismatch.
And the Heard that starting lineup. Of course, John Elmore, the all-time leading scorer at Marshall and in Conference USA. Lots of guys who can fill it up, and they waste no time. It's Chris Coakley, and quickly Heard that out with a three-point lead.
Of course, Coke was a big-time player in Conference USA as well. Four-year starter at UAB. Actually, he was the sixth man of the year, his freshman and sophomore years, but he was a key player for some good teams. UAB went to the NCAA tournament his freshman year.
Everything but the finish for Coakley on that layup attempt. This Heard that team, constructed primarily of Marshall alumni, as we said, but in talking to John Elmore, they decided if they wanted to compete on a more national stage in this tournament, they had to go out and get some other guys.
Yeah, Ja'Cory Williams, you'll see him come off the bench, former Arkansas player in Middle Tennessee standout.
LJ Coward, former NAIA guy, not recognized by the NCAA at Georgetown College, knocking that down, and Coakley airborne. And quickly with five early points.
LJ Coward won a national championship at Georgetown NAIA school in 2019.
And one of the best parts of TBT, you get to showcase a lot of guys that you're not necessarily familiar with. And Trayvon Allen again for the second time.
Well, get familiar with Trayvon because he is a special player. Here he is with the basketball, 21 points a game at Idaho. That is not easy to do, especially when you consider you're going to be at the top of that scouting report night in and night out, drawing a crowd, but it doesn't matter. He gets a look, he's going to let it fly.
Trayvon Allen, looking for a pro career, says, sign me.
Yes, sir. This is a great audition, a great stage. Only 197 countries watching and everybody in America. So this is a great opportunity for him.
Don't blink in this game. On Elmore from downtown.
How about
make that John, excuse me.
Oh, is that John there? Yeah, so both Elmores getting on the board early. Of course, they're coached by their dad, Gay Elmore. VMI standout in the 1970s.
Allen again letting it fly. There's no such thing as a heat check at TBT.
No, it's just letting it go. Everybody thinks they're hot.
Brown and trying to split the double. And a foul, our officiating crew this afternoon, Anthony Eads, Jamal Rawls, and Ryan Sassano. Well, at FanDuel, you can enter fantasy TBT contests, compete for real cash payouts all tournament long. Trayvon Allen, rostered by a little over 20% of the FanDuel lineups in today's TBT fantasy games.
So 1 in 5 of the fans know what they're talking about, right?
Yes, they do. Early on, they're loving that at home. 7 points for Allen. Getting this Peoria team started. And Zach Charles, who played his college ball at Eastern Kentucky.
And even that shot went in. I mean, this is scintillating to start the Sunday morning, Sunday afternoon here.
Yeah, we were wondering yesterday about the adjustment period, getting back into 5-on-5 in a gym.
Yeah.
No adjustment here. Not day two.
No, so far, both teams have looked like they've been playing for the last 3 months, 4 months. But, you know, of course, you know, some teams have been able to get together in a quarantine situation. Of course, all these teams the last four or five days have been able to do that.
That's the former Conference USA Player of the Year, Ja'Cory Williams, on the rise up.
And Ja'Cory just lit up Conference USA in that one season he played for Kermit Davis at Middle Tennessee. He was just a matchup problem. No one could stop him in that high post area. You saw that on display just now. Great switch.
Getting the quick hands. The longer defender on Allen. Charles on the rise. And there's Williams into the game already with a bucket and a rebound. The bounce game with the left. Coakley attacking the glass. And trying to follow that up without even coming down.
You have to know the scouting report. You can't let Ja'Cory go left. Left-handed player. He'll fake you right. And he's going to come back to that left hand, so be there. That time, a little tardy on it, and able to step through clean and get a nice smooch off the glass early going.
Trying to attack the basket. It's Coward. And Browning running the floor.
That's poor transition defense right there. Two no-nos. They didn't stop the ball, and no one covered the basket. A run out, and now a stoppage of play.
Now, Stevie Browning getting out in transition, a staple under Dan D'Antoni. Up and down the floor, score a lot of points, run and gun.
And that was a few guys in yellow shirts jogging right there, giving up an easy one. You don't want to do that because this team is such a good scoring team anyway. And they're going to try to take every opportunity to get out in transition, so you have to limit that.
This is a Peoria All-Stars team that ended up coming together in the last 2 weeks. They're put together by their GM, Willie Williams, who's a Peoria native, but ended up in the quarantine bubble as one of the four teams that were basically on standby, and it worked out in their favor. Best Virginia ended up going home. Team Jimmy V ended up going home. So they were the third option, but are happy to be here. Shot clock down to 7. And Zach Charles with another quick miss. And Williams the rebound. Elmore unabated to the basket. Gets it back from Zach Smith. And look at the rise. Testing the legs early on in the afternoon matinee.
My goodness, a little cleanup around the bucket right there early. I love it.
Coward misses the mid-range. And Williams, maybe a little too unselfish, wanted to dish it off to Smith.
Who can blame him after Smith cleaned up that nice miss with two hands? Beautiful.
Lundy drawing the contact, but heard that up by 7 here at Columbus. Up and down. TBT is presented by Puma Basketball. By Air Force Reserve. Explore your opportunities with Air Force Reserve. And COVID testing for TBT is brought to us by Vault Health. Vault Health specializes in cutting-edge personalized health care for men. You can learn more at vaulthealth.com.
Exactly. We can have our big go to the board and that's it.
Yeah.
Everybody else got to get back. Hey, on P2, we're going away. You got to get away and out.
Sit down. Okay. Are you good, B? Can you sit down? I'm both good. All y'all sit down.
Because look, here's our advantage. They old.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They running and flying up and down the court now, but as the game wears along, they're going to slow the fuck down.
We're good. We're good. So we got
We can have our big go to the board and that's it.
Yeah.
Everybody else got to get back. Hey, on P2, we're going away. You got to get away and out.
Sit down. Are you good, B? Can you sit down? Both of all y'all sit down.
Because look, here's our advantage. They old.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They running and flying. They old.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? Here's our advantage. They old.
Yep.
look, here's our advantage. They old.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They running and flying up and down the court now, but as the game wears on, they're going to slow the fuck down.
We're good. We're good.
So, we have to execute our game plan, bro.
If we have good shots, we take them. But if not, make the extra pass, guys.
Right.
Sometimes it's that extra pass. One, two, boom. Instead of just, I got it, I'm shooting with a guy when I got a guy wide open.
How y'all feel energy-wise? Good? Good?
Back at Columbus, we go in the huddle, presented by Puma, with the Peoria All-Stars.
And Trayvon Allen has been nothing short of sensational in the early going, despite drawing the attention of the boys in green, but to no avail. He got that ball screen, and all he needs is a tiny window, and he's coming through. Another knockdown from the perimeter. Trayvon Allen carrying the load as we expected here in the early going.
And the up and down type of pace that we expected, though it is a 9-0 run for Heard That over the last 3 minutes. As part of game one of a quadruple header, day two of the $1 million winner-take-all tournament, we hand out four more bids into the round of 16. Did four yesterday. Luke Monlundy of the Peoria All-Stars, his winning share sent with Zell. $120,000. What would you do with it, Scar?
120?
Yeah.
Buy a car. No, I'm just kidding.
At least he's honest.
No, I would never spend that much on a car. Got two little ones, man. I gotta put it away for them.
Give me that 529. That's right. Ja'Cory Williams making it a 7-point lead for Heard That. And scoring drought for the Peoria All-Stars. No field goals now in over 3.5 minutes. And right on cue, Luke Monlundy changes that.
That was a great look for Lundy. Now, this Heard That team and Marshall in general isn't known for their defensive prowess. Dan D'Antoni, who of course we know very well, does not like people to talk about how bad they are on defense. He wants to talk about the pace and the reason why other teams get so many more looks, and that's why they give up many points. But, you know, the defense commitment has been there the last couple of years, but there has been some times from that Heard team where they were just kind of letting you score so they can go down and score.
Look, it doesn't get ignored. It's just not their first priority.
It's definitely not on the high up on that list.
Catch and shoot for Trayvon Allen. And Williams, already huge on the glass. That's his third rebound.
They do such a good job of spreading you out, getting on that perimeter. Oh, look at this.
Look out. Good afternoon from Columbus, Zach Smith.
Zach Smith, Texas Tech standout, has been dominant around that paint in the early going. Two hammers.
We had talked to our friend Grant Traylor from the Huntington Herald Dispatch earlier this week, the Marshall beat writer. And he had mentioned Zach Smith, a workout partner of John Elmore, said, one of the most athletic kids I've
good
ever
team,
seen.
Hey, listen, that pass was nowhere near where it needed to be for most people, for mortals. Yeah. But Zach Smith rises to the occasion.
And Jake Coward with a quick drive. And the good ball reversal, Ryan Luther newly in, but left it on the rim. Another guy that played against these Marshall guys. Luther played his college basketball at Pitt, finished up at Arizona.
So you get a couple of Power Five guys in there to pick up that lineup a little bit.
Smith now trying to take it off the dribble and fouled by Lundy.
Take a look at Zach Smith. Flying the friendly skies. First the ball screen. Assault on the rim. My goodness. That pass was about 5 feet behind his head, even with the throw.
You get a movie on that flight, you get drinks, you get everything you want. That's executive platinum status.
My goodness, flying the friendly skies.
Inside of a minute here in a fast and furious opening quarter. Matt Martucci, Tim Scarborough. Jen Hale is our sideline reporter.
Back, Zach, Zach, back in the middle.
Bringing us all the great content from Columbus. Lundy lost it with five to shoot. Smith took it away. And Santino DiTrepano with a quick assist. And Luther filling the lane.
Great pass by DiTrepano. Normally, when you look at Marshall, that would have been a three-pointer, but neither one of those guys played at Marshall, so they ran a traditional
fast break for a layup. Zach, back up!
Final 5 seconds. There Who else? Trayvon Allen. And out of bounds.
1.1. I'm putting Aaron Menzies in at 7'3" and let him stand under the goal and throw it to him. They're not going to do it, though.
Interesting couple of 7-footers. We've only seen Menzies so far.
Didn't get wrong.
Won't even get this off.
Nope. That was some defense from the boys in green.
Now, end of one here at Columbus. A 61% first quarter for her that. And this will certainly help with the percentage. Zach Smith, frequent flyer miles, upgraded.
Yep.
-17 is your score early on here at the basketball tournament on ESPN. Heard That versus the Peoria All-Stars. You're looking at Team Heard That in the arena, and take a look. This is what life has been like for the past 5 or 6, 7 days for all of us here in the Ohio bubble. Masks at all times. You have to stay with your group, social distancing, so you can be around your team, but you can't commingle with other teams or other people. It has been serious. The good news is it's working. All 89 participants in today's games all passed their COVID test, all cleared. Matt, over 1,800 COVID tests have been given so far in the tournament. And the good news is, again, the protocol is detailed, but it's working. It's keeping people safe.
And Jen, so glad to hear that as we start our E and J family spotlight for the afternoon. And what better a guest to bring on, part of our TBT family, our lead analyst for TBT. It's the great Fran Fraschilla joining us. Fran, day two, game one. Welcome to the broadcast.
Hey, what a field day we had yesterday. Great job by you guys. And I'm just so tickled that we've got basketball being played in July in America. It's great.
Fran, what'd you take away from that first day? What were some of your observations, big picture?
You know, the same thing that I usually see, Tooch, guys that we heard of in college that we followed who are even better now, some guys we never heard of. You know, the young man from Florida Southern yesterday, the guard.
Kevin Capers.
Yeah, Capers, tremendous player, playing really well overseas. So that's the beauty of the TBT. these guys are all, for the most part, 98% of them, professional players playing around the world. They not only play at a higher level than they did when they were in college, they know how to play the game. They don't need a ton of practice. They've all been well coached around the world, and the basketball is exciting. I'll tell you, Nationwide Arena on TV looks great as well.
It really does, doesn't it? And the backdrop, and you know, you wouldn't even know that there's not a lot, that there aren't any fans there. This is great, and I hope the NBA does the same thing when they come back in the next few weeks. But I got to ask you, Coach, the Elam ending scenario. You know, we talked about this a little bit, and you told me that the people should always call the timeout before they go, if they have the lead, just so they can have the possession. Explain that a little bit.
Well, I think, Tim, that once you have the lead in the ball and you get under four, and, you know, you're better off just taking the timeout, setting the target score, and then going to work. Then your team is pretty much focused on the job at hand. I think when you let that clock get under, you know, 4 minutes and you have the lead, it's possible you could lose the lead before the next dead ball or timeout called, and then you're behind the eight ball. So I would say one thing about the Elam ending that we've all learned, I think you and I would agree, that the coaches and players in this tournament who are getting used to it, they got to be on their game in that final 4 minutes, because if you make the wrong decision regarding Elam ending, you're going to put yourself, your team, behind the eight ball.
Yeah, we've talked about it for years, Coach. It's something that you have to strategize going into it. Otherwise, you could be caught in a really tough situation. Five seeds, top five, Carmen's Crew, Overseas Elite, and Eberline Drive, you know, some of those other ones. Who jumps out at you, Boeheim's Army? You know, who jumps out at you in terms of who ends up running through this thing? Is it Carmen's Crew on a repeat, or is it one of those other ones?
Eberline Drive, they're dangerous. They got a great backcourt. And Josh Majette, who played for the Atlanta Hawks, Dusty Hannes, who was close to being the MVP of the G League this year, and I believe he got a quick call up with the Grizzlies. He's an NBA-level player. That's an NBA-level backcourt. And so Eberline Drive is dangerous. The money team is loaded. The winner of this game obviously is going to see that team. Their roster is really loaded, but as I've told people before, chemistry is so important, and we know Overseas Elite's going to have great chemistry, but they're going to have to get Joe Johnson fit into that chemistry.
Yeah, Coach, that's a great point. Seven-time All-Star Joe Johnson is part of that roster. What about Golden Eagles?
Well, I like Golden Eagles. You know, you like their chemistry because they all know each other. Joe Chapman does a good job with those guys. He has a great AAU program, player development program in Milwaukee. A lot of those former Eagles, Golden Eagles, who are pro players, will work out with Joe in the offseason. Travis Diener, Dwight Bikes, DJO, that's an explosive backcourt. Jameel Wilson, he's been an Elam ending killer in the last 2 years. He knows how to get it done at the end. I really like their team. They're getting a little longer in the tooth, but they still have great experience, and DJO and Dwight Bikes still are elite players that have been in the NBA.
Well, Fran, Tim and I won't see you out here, but looking forward to you getting out here and looking forward to hearing your call. Always love to have you as part of the TBT family, and looking forward to the next time we cross paths. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks, Mac. You guys keep up the great job. I'm watching all day today.
All right, Fran. Thanks, man. Thanks for joining us.
The great Fran Fraschilla, who ends up as part of our E&J family spotlight. For more information, go to ejbrandy.com. It's a 14-point lead while we were talking to Coach. Or heard that. Stevie Brown getting a layup. Another three-pointer by the Elmores. And Chris Coakley adding to his scoring total.
I mean, John Elmore delivered the package right at the doorstep, and Coke was there for the answer. Chris Coakley.
He just talked about team chemistry and experience. This has heard that team that they haven't played a ton of TBT games, but they've played TBT games.
Yes, they have, and they've played together. But this Peoria team, you know, they are scrappy enough to get back in this game. But they have to eliminate some of these deflections and turnovers because they will get hammered. And right there, that was a great golden opportunity that they missed.
And misconnection between Zach Charles and Luke Mont-Lundy. Taylor having to extend, and foul going down.
And transition is very key for this Marshall group. The Herd, that team, they like to run, and that pass was put right on the money. And Coakley with a little smile. Have a Coke and a smile.
That little high step. Points in the paint, by the way, for the Herd, 20-2. Heard that.
Mr. Rev, we got some next dead ball.
Pretty much all layups. Layups and dunks.
Layups, dunks, and threes, of course. The splashdowns from downtown, they will make it rain all day.
On the catch and shoot for Peoria All-Stars. Lundy grabbed the rebound. Menzies, and having a tough time setting up lobs, finishing dunks.
Yeah, that's two dunks. That's 4 points that should be on the scoreboard that are not.
And on Elmore, sniping as usual.
Yeah, this is a great opportunity for this Herd, that team. You know, the Zoom, the TBT guys, talking to them, you know, the guys who kind of are the insiders for TBT, they like that Herd, that team. They think they can make a run in this tournament. I don't know if I agree with that, but I think they're going to be a tough out. But there's just the teams that are waiting. I mean, the top eight teams who haven't played yet, there are some loaded teams. We talked a little bit about TMT, Everline Drive, ALS. I don't think these guys are quite at that level. And I didn't even mention Boeheim's Army, Carmen's crew, or Overseas Elite.
And there's Menzies running the lane.
Finally, they get one to go, a dunk.
That'll catch and shoot for Browning. Want it done, but no sir, there's on Elmore. Don't give him a second chance.
Smoke him if you got him. Man, everybody who picks that ball up from beyond the arc is letting it fly. Come out with a hand up.
Ryan Luther says, isn't his brother the guy that scored 2,600 plus points? I can play too.
Coward. LJ with the answer, but they'll need a lot more than that.
14-point Herd, that lead in Columbus. And by American Eagle, all day, every day. Be comfortable, be you. Official spirit of TBT. TBT is brought to you by Air Force Reserve. Explore your opportunities with Air Force Reserve. And by American Eagle. All day, every day. Be comfortable. Be you. And by E&J Brandy, the official spirit of TBT. TBT is big. TBT is brought to you by Air Force Reserve. Explore your opportunities with Air Force Reserve. And by American Eagle. All day, every day. Be comfortable. be you. And by E&J Branding, the official spirit of TBT.
And Tooch, like most Marshall games, this Thundering Herd team would put on a lesson in three-conomics. I, Elmore, then the brother, the bigger scorer, John Elmore, then Ryan Taylor from downtown. All those guys have splashed it down from downtown. And then I, again from three. He's got the YMCA body, but don't let that fool you. This guy can ball.
Guy at the Y, where you look at him and you think, can
you're
he play?
You're not picking him, right? You're not going to pick him.
Yeah, no.
No, I got my five, even though you came by yourself.
I got next. No, yeah. You don't.
But Elmore is getting it done right now.
14-point Herd that lead. Shooting almost 55% from the field. And 50 from three. They've already hit seven of them in the first half. And going up top, wanted Rondell Watson.
How many people put Ott Elmore in their lineup at FanDuel? I'm going to say 0%.
They won't make the same mistake twice if they move on.
If your last name is Elmore, you probably wouldn't even play him. But he is balling right now.
Yes, he is. Koch Barr, newly in for the Peoria All-Stars, played his college ball at Bradley. And a guy from South Sudan has overcome a lot to come to the United States.
It was a great foul there to stop that short 3-on-1 break.
Our next top-ranked card is Tuesday night in Las Vegas with 31-2, Jose Zepeda taking on 17-1, Kendo Castaneda, who's taking this fight on short notice in the 10-round junior welterweight main event. Coverage of the prelims begins 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific, right here on ESPN, ESPN Deportes, and the ESPN app. I don't know. Do we have a fight here, Scarborough?
Well, this is what you call a TKO right now. Peoria can get up off the mat, and they still have time, but the Herd, that group is going to go for the knockout punch early. I can promise you that.
Now he is Tim Scarborough, Matt Martucci, and our sideline reporter Jen Hale. The first of what's four games here, day two of a quad header. And Kendall Davis with another quick three.
Obviously, you're going to need that, but another special delivery at the basket. Couldn't convert, and wise foul, but they're going to need to get stops. The anatomy of any comeback is not just the scoring. It's the most important thing is the getting the stops at the other end. They'll have to do that. But right here, you see Davis coming off a pin down, popping out to the wing, a simple pass, catch and shoot.
Zach Smith to the line. Former four-year starter down in Lubbock at Texas Tech. And a workout partner out west of John Elmore. Kind of how this connection all started. His winning share sent with Zell right at $100,000.
How would you like to get that text right from Zell?
Get a stop.
I mean, it's life-changing,
isn't
it?
Except again and again and again, right?
Yeah, hit accept. We were with, I don't know if you were still around in Chicago, but I remember when
good rebound, Luke. Get it out.
John Diebler got his. I was standing right next to him, and he was like, it's in there. And then they filmed that again. He was saying it's in there when they were in the locker room.
And it just keeps on coming. This time it's Ryan Luther with the eighth from the outside.
One of the things about the D'Antoni system is all five guys are threats from downtown, even the bigs. And the same thing with the Houston Rockets, right? Mike D'Antoni, they spread the floor. You got to come out and guard everybody on the perimeter because they're all threats.
Allen, who had the big start to this game. And mid-range, first time we've heard from Trayvon Allen in a little while since those first couple minutes.
He's got 11, I believe, now, or 9. But, you know, when you think about the way the NBA is played, the game is just different. The D'Antoni system has really kind of revolutionized the way we watch basketball and the way it's played.
Time for our American Eagle fan of the game. American Eagle all day, every day. Be comfortable. Be you. Casey Flight filling out her TBT bracket. I know Tim Scarborough did his.
I do. I have one. I got one on the TBT website that, you know, people usually pick apart when I pick them, and with good reason. I don't think I've picked one right this year since I've been doing TBT for 4 years now. And you know what's funny is the years that I didn't pick Overseas Elite, they won it. Last year I picked them, and guess what happened?
Of course.
Right? So this year I stayed away from those guys. I picked Challenge ALS. Sorry, Challenge ALS.
The Scarborough jinx is in effect.
The Scarborough jinx is on you. Maybe they can overcome it, though. We'll see.
Gender Rob.
Final 5 seconds here on the shot clock.
Get loud,
let's go. Hey, Smith, rebound in the miss.
You've been hearing me during the game.
Elmore. And quickly rebounded by Ja'Cory Williams. And heard that. If you've seen Marshall basketball under Dan D'Antoni, that's pretty much what this looked like here in the first half. 46 points up on the board and 8 made threes en route to an almost 56% first half overall.
And Toots, when you think about that, they did that in 18 game minutes. Effortless. They are terrific from downtown. Again, they're not a first-tier team in this tournament, but boy, are they fun to watch when they get it going.
What happened, man?
And hoping to put together a nice little run here. This is a good start halfway there toward becoming our fifth team that we'll send out of the round of 24. Let's check in with Jen Hale and the head coach, Gay Elmore.
Thanks, Matt. We've actually got John Elmore with us right off the court. We've barely given him a chance to catch his breath. John, commanding lead. What did you like about what your squad did that first half?
Playing again. A lot of us have grown up with each other, so getting a chance to lace them up again with my brothers, my family. It's an awesome feeling. We came out focused, had a lot of energy, but we're having a lot of fun.
How do you handle Trayvon Allen's second half? You know the Peoria All-Stars aren't going to lay down.
Oh, no, good player. Capable scorer, good player. So we just got to stick to our game plan, keep having fun, keep making highlights, and try to get the dub.
We love the highlights, John. Thanks so much for your time. Good luck.
Thank you. I love you, Tori.
Matt.
Thank you, Jen. And a little shout out to his fiance, Tori Dent. They have a little one on the way coming in September. So impressive first half, 46 up on the board. And the Elmore name stamped all over it, except Ott at the forefront. Heard that, up by 14. Stats, highlights, and a visit with Rob Kennedy from the Hoop Group. Coming up.
Give me one of the two.
That's fun.
the basketball tournament. Heard that, taking on the Peoria All-Stars, 46-32 is your score. And this is just the beginning today. We have a quadruple header coming up for you. You are not going to want to miss Team Hines in Sideline Cancer. That's going to be some amazing basketball. Team Hines coming in with a chip on their shoulder because they did not receive a bye. Heartfire versus Men of Mackey, Purdue alum. Are you ready? And then, of course, Armored Athlete versus Power of the Paw, your Clemson alums. And that is just the weekend. We are bringing in now TBT insider Rob Kennedy. Rob, we have a fantastic 10 days of basketball for folks. And starting Monday, that's when the big boys start playing. What can we expect?
Well, certainly, those are the eight teams with byes. But as you mentioned, there's some teams, including Team Hines, who got to the semifinals last year, who thought they should have gotten byes. But it's setting up to be a great bracket.
No one has been able to play basketball since March. It has been such a difficult process to get the tournament going. But here you are. How do you evaluate the basketball we've seen so far and what you think we're going to see coming up?
Well, we had a great day yesterday, including a dunk to end the game in a tie game in Elam ending. Doesn't get any better than that with CP3 with that great comeback last night. Terrific play here. Heard that. I hear they throw up threes, and they made eight of them in the first half, so don't surprise. But a great day of basketball. But you mentioned everybody waiting to get back and get going. And there's so many great stories within the tournament. And a couple coming up for Heartfire, right? You think about Isaiah Austin. We're all happy to be back, but nobody more so than Isaiah with all that he went through after being drafted and then finding out about the heart condition and not being able to play in the NBA and now being back playing. And Billy Kennedy, the former coach at Texas A&M and having to step aside with Parkinson's and now being back on the sideline. So you talk about guys who are really appreciative of the opportunity to get back and play, maybe none more than those two guys for Heartfire.
Those are amazing stories, Rob. Let me ask you, this whole quarantine experience, it's been new and different for all of us. What will you remember? What have you taken away from this period so far? Because you've been on the inside of this from the very beginning.
Yeah, we've been here now 12, 13 days. I think the biggest thing is how everyone has bought in. And initially, that first 24 hours when you're in quarantine, your guys are coming out of quarantine like, I'm out, I'm good, you know. And again, we're in a luxury hotel in the Hyatt. Your meals are coming to your room. But just not having those same freedoms that you're used to. Wearing a mask all day. Well, guess what? It's for your safety and everybody else's. And the compliance has been unbelievable. And so I think that's the biggest thing that I'll take away from it, that everyone has been in it to help each other out. All everybody wants to do is be able to play basketball. You know, and I'm looking there at Aaron Kraft. This is his last time. This is a guy who's going to be going to medical school. This is going to be his last time playing basketball. And so everybody who's wearing a mask and doing all the social distancing is making sure that Aaron gets a chance for this to be his last basketball experience. And so that's what I'm going to take away from this new normal. No. There's nothing new and there's nothing normal about it. But it has been an amazing experience.
So well said. Rob, congratulations at the end of the day on bringing basketball back, because it has been no small feat for the TBT staff to get this tournament off the ground.
No, and it's a Herculean effort by a ton of people, but we're just happy that we're back playing hoops.
We are as well. Rob, thanks for your time and enjoy the rest of basketball today.
All right, thanks, Jen.
Of course, we've got several teams in TBT that play for something bigger for themselves. Teams like Sideline Cancer, Team ALS, and Jimmy V for the V Foundation for Cancer Research. Carrying on with that tradition, in 2020, E&J Brandy and TBT are proud to announce their partnership with the National Urban League. That is the historic civil rights organization dedicated to economic empowerment, equality, and social justice for those underserved in America. Along with a $100,000 donation, E&J and TBT have invited our final four teams to play for the local chapter of their choice. Find out more information at NUL.org. And keep it here on ESPN. We've got more TBT action after this.
Now, right outside the Nationwide Arena here at Columbus, as it's day two, game one, halftime of the basketball tournament, round of 24, 14-point lead for her that. Matt Martucci and Tim Scarborough here at the TBT Broadcast Center in Indianapolis. Scar, I thought we were back in Conference USA for a second there. Marshall, 46 points, and it's actually heard that, but feels like the Marshall team, the way that they're playing.
Well, the pace of play certainly was Dan D'Antoni's team. They were terrific in that first half, raining threes from downtown. A symphony of string music, cashing it in. Elmore, then the other Elmore. And then Ryan Taylor got into the action. Everybody all night long, like Lionel Richie, once, twice, three times, a lady. And Ott again from three. And then Ryan got into the act again, bam, from three. Ryan Luther, the other Ryan. But I tell you what, this herd, that team, they can shoot you out. You have to come ready and prepared to contest the three because they are going to let it fly, as you see.
And what you don't see there, fast break points in the first half, 15-2 for her that, getting up and down the floor. And you might have heard Peoria All-Stars in our Puma in the huddle say, these guys are old. They're going to get tired. I don't know about that just yet.
I don't know. Old is very relative, isn't it?
Yeah, they're not that old. What's that even mean?
Yeah, I mean, old. I mean, these guys graduated in 2018, 2019. I mean, that's not old. But I tell you what, I had to get some Lionel Richie references in there because coordinated producer Mike Burks had us playing James Ingram a little bit earlier today.
Well, from the Peoria All-Stars side, Jen Hale was able to talk to Willie Williams.
Indeed, Matt. You know, the thing about this Peoria team, half of them just met each other when they got here to Columbus, Ohio. So really, that first half was the definition of knocking the rust off. So Willie tells me he expects a much better half the second half. Defense, that's the key. Get back on defense and get in Herd That's faces. Make things tough. We'll see if they can do it.
Yeah, tough proposition for so many offensive options. And there's Ja'Cory Williams.
Man.
Chance to go to the line and get the old-fashioned three-point play.
And Ja'Cory Williams going to the block. That left hand is deadly. And then just when you think it's safe to get in the water, and that's not even a three-point shot. That's the first real two-pointer outside the paint that they've taken today.
Well, how exactly do you defend her that? That's a great first question for our next E&J Family Spotlight guest. It's the head coach of the money team, David Nurse. So, David, you're taking a look at what you're seeing. 49 points up on the board already for these guys. How do you stop this if they're your opponent?
Man, they can really shoot it. That's huge credit to them, the pace they're playing, their shooting ability. But that's why we get to watch these games and scout them and be prepared. And obviously, I mean, we got to take away the three-point shot.
And that's exactly right, David. We, of course, we cover Conference USA, so we see these guys do this. The teams that are able to get out and contest those threes and make these guys drivers, normally they're able to get out successfully. Talk about that a little bit, and then talk about all the talent that you have assembled on your team. My goodness.
Yeah, you're right. I mean, we have to be aware of what they're doing, but our team is extremely talented. We have great diversity at every position. We have all the tools that it takes to be a champion in this tournament. But the thing I love the most about our team isn't just our talent. It's the character. It's the hard work. It's the tenacity, the toughness. And a big thing with this is chemistry, yes. And we've been able to come together in Zoom calls and team meetings, and everybody is in on the same page together. And that's the key.
Jordan Crawford, Tony Roten, those guys are bucket getters. You got Willie Reed, who seems to play on a different team every year for TBT, searching for those $1 million. Is this the year Willie Reed gets a text from Zell?
That's going to happen. Absolutely. Willie's actually the one that asked me to coach this team, so Willie's getting that money. He's getting it.
My man, I hear you.
David, who's your most underrated player in your mind?
Wow, that's a really good question. I don't think we even look at it as players who are the top talents or the underrated players. We're all literally together as one, and everybody on our team can one night be really hot and one night maybe one guy's setting all the screens or diving for loose balls. But the thing is that guy, they don't care about whether they're the top guy or the bottom guy. We're in it to win, and we have one mission. We're all in it together.
Well, you're into life optimization coaching. You're a motivational speaker. Give us a preview of what that first round, that round of 16 speeches is going to sound like.
Well, if I can get them coming out there from the start of the game with energy, with passion, like I try to do in my motivational talks, then we'll be in a good spot. And I'll have to probably use this experience for a talk to come up.
How happy are you to have basketball back, David?
Unbelievably happy. It's the best. Like, I'm just juiced up right now wanting to get out there and coach. And just the last basketball I got to see was my uncle win the championship with the Toronto Raptors, which was an amazing thing to see. So we got to bring another ring back for the family, TBT ring.
Well, he's renowned as one of the best shooters in the country, maybe even in the world, David Nurse. Who's your favorite TBT shooter so far?
Favorite TBT shooter? Whoever's making threes on my team is my favorite TBT shooter.
Well, you're going to have plenty of them in this tournament and in this next matchup. If it's heard that, a couple days away, Thursday, 2 p.m. Eastern, little afternoon matinee. Wish you the best of luck. Thanks for stopping by.
Thank you for having me, guys. Appreciate
it. All right, David. Good luck, man.
That's David Nurse, also an author. Pivot and Go, the 29-day mindset blueprint to redefine and achieve your success.
Guy's a winner, isn't he?
Gonna have some extra time this summer. We might have to pick that up. 16-point heard that lead and foul trouble for Peoria. All-Stars, more trouble coming. Ja'Cory Williams, special delivery.
My goodness, if you let them turn the corner on those ball screens, that dive guy is going to kill you. Great lob, great delivery, great finish by Ja'Cory Williams. Get it out.
And Allen gets it punched out by Luther. Everybody getting in on the act for Herb that.
And, you know, we talk about the offense, but they're not playing bad defense either. I mean, some of it is Peoria doesn't have a lot of flow to their offense. But give some credit to Herb that.
On our dunk meter, I think this is number 3 for the day.
See the ball screen and the, and the lob. What a finish by Ja'Cory Williams. If that big doesn't show, and he didn't because he was trying to get back to Corey, to Ja'Cory Williams, and then a great pass, and that is just an easy finish. John Elmore has done that a million times.
Yeah, I was just going to say, I think that's what people forget about John Elmore. Yes, he did have 2,638 career points at Marshall. Right. He had a lot of assists, too.
Tons of assists, because they just scored a lot of points. Again, they had a lot of possessions, but they were efficient as well.
Already with 6 of them this afternoon.
He averaged 7 assists a game his senior year.
Yeah, feeling like I heard that runaway. So you get a look at Ja'Cory Williams, who's one of the ringers, if you will. Talked about him 3 years at Arkansas, 1 at Middle Tennessee. It's a really good story. Kermit Davis basically took a flyer on him after, you know, what were some personal setbacks at Arkansas.
Well, Kermit recruited him out of college, out of high school as well. He didn't come, ended up in the SEC.
And Allen with some goaltending by Herb that.
But you know, we talked about the pace of the game. In the last 5 years, Marshall in college, another lob play there, couldn't convert that time. But Marshall in college, they were number 4 in tempo the last 5 years, and number 2 in average amount of possession length, okay? So you talk about pace, number 2 in the nation over the course of 5 years, according to KenPom. So when you think about that, of course they're going to score a lot of points and they're going to give up a lot of points, but you have to be ready to match their pace if you're going to be able to get with them.
That last foul on Luke Mon-Lundy, his 5th. Allen continuing the individual assault. Now 16 for Trayvon Allen. He's 7 of 12 from the field. Oh, Williams sold the fake and got the extra step. Count it, plus 1.
Got popped in the eyes. Looked like he's going to shake that off so he can go get this 3-point play opportunity. But a great ball fake, pass fake. Watch what he does here, Tooch. I'm not really going that way. Euro back to the left, and again, he always comes back to that left when he goes to score. People know it, but very few people have been able to stop it from what I've seen covering Ja'Cory Williams. And by the way, Tooch, those analytical stats that I gave you, I'm not an analytics guy, but my guy Charlie Hagley from Marshall's, he's their analyst, along with Steve Cotton. Charlie sent that to me, so I figured I'd use it. Thank you, Charlie.
A 14-point Herd that lead. Elmore, elevator up for Smith.
Man.
And like, didn't even have to touch that
one. It's like clockwork, though. When that guy sets the ball screen, if you let the guard turn the corner, the big has to show. When he shows, the other big, the offensive big is diving, they're just going to lob it up to him. And if you got guys with bungees like that, it is lights out.
How do you defend that? You don't.
It can be defended, but it really is hard. That's why Houston Rockets score so many points. That's why the Phoenix Suns with Steve Nash scored so many points back in the day when both D'Antonis were on the bench.
Speaking of which, John Elmore's favorite player growing up?
Steve Nash.
Yes, sir. Look out, Ja'Cory Williams.
I didn't know they were doing the dunk contest this year at TBT. Who knew?
Lots of posterizations going on. I think we're at five now.
Nice move.
Davis got the step to the basket. Or make it LJ Cower.
Cower's got 12. Allen's got 18.
And here comes Smith on the trailer from Elmore. Give him 7 assists.
But it is like a sieve at that other end. Heard that is scoring virtually every possession.
Now Zach Smith having a perfect game from the field so far, which is easy to do when you're set up the way he's been.
They're all dunks.
Allen got the fake and nearly got the bounce.
Heard that is shooting a blistering 59% from the field. Can that
Columbus,
get it done for you?
Yeah, Columbus by way of Huntington for the boys in green. TBT is presented by Puma Basketball. By FanDuel. Your home for TBT action. Win cash and other prizes all tournament long. And by American Eagle. All day, every day. Be comfortable. Be you.
Stay in with Tino. Huh? Yeah, but he wants to cut out and we don't have any other guard. Huh? Go ahead and get back in.
See how quick that was?
Yeah, Coke, start down. Just a thumb. You're out. Out. Rondo, Tino, Zach, RT, and Stevie. If you can't go, let us know.
I just want to have this or there. Hey, get this thing.
Rondo, Tino, Zach, RT, and Stevie. If you can't go, let us know. Rondo, Tino, Zach, RT, and Stevie. If you can't go, let us know.
That's In the Huddle here at the basketball tournament presented by Puma Basketball. And Gay Elmore certainly liking what he sees out there from his guys, Tim Scarborough. And first half it was threes, second half Life above the rim feels good.
Yeah, the splashes from downtown in the first half and then the rim wrecking in the second. Jump with me if you want to go viral. I mean, this is, look at this hammer right here. You don't want any parts of that unless you want to end up on the gram.
Now there's Zach Smith. Fans that heard that team share sent with Zell, each of them evenly split $100,000. Though I thought I heard Stevie Browning said they were all going to take it to Vegas and maybe throw it on red. Let's check in with the third member of our team, Jen Hale.
Matt, one of the things about this team that is so much fun, it is a family affair for the Elmores. Of course, everybody knows that guy, John. Legend for the Thundering Herd. Led them to their first tournament appearance in 31 years, leading to this school's only NCAA tourney win in history. That was 2018, knocked off Wichita. Of course, he is the younger brother of Ott Elmore, the team GM. And you might think, hey, there's some brotherly competition, some sibling rivalry. Nah, Ott tells me that he and his brother John look forward to this every summer because it's such a bonding time that they wouldn't normally get. And of course, you mentioned their dad, Gay, a little bit earlier. In years past, he's been here coaching. He's watching from home, certainly weighing in for this team. And he's, of course, who gave them their love of basketball. One thing that the Elmore brothers are very proud of this year, you might notice the name change. Heard that. In the past, they've been the West Virginia Wildcats. They have wanted to make this a Marshall alumni team for years, but didn't have enough Marshall alums. This year, they've got six. That qualifies to be an official alumni team, hence the name change, Matt.
Nice.
Yeah, heard that. And I think we'd be remiss if we didn't mention the great women behind those three men, their mom, Beth, and sisters, Lydia and Abby. There's Trayvon Allen to the free throw line for Peoria All-Stars. Yeah, it's been kind of the one-man show for the 10th seed.
Looking for his 20th point, didn't get it there. He's been good, but at the other end, they have just not been able to stop. Heard that all afternoon. They have dug themselves a huge hole as we start to think about the Elam ending scenario. What a hill they're going to have to climb.
Bench points, points in the paint, fast break points, you name it. Heard that getting it done in pretty much every category.
I got to take issue with one thing Jen said about Ott and John. I've watched those guys in shoot-arounds go at it, and most of the time it seemed like Ott gets the better of his younger brother John because he knows all of his moves. And that was, of course, when Ott was a few pounds less than he is now and he could play some defense.
Ott Elmore, he's becoming a fan favorite, though, TBT.
Absolutely.
Basically taking over the Twitter account with all these made threes.
Next round, the FanDuel percentage is going to be up for Ott. Up from zero, I believe. I don't know how many people played him.
LJ Coward.
Playing a matchup zone there, trying to stop those pin down screens from taking place.
Yeah, setting up Menzies, who gets the layup and will head to the line.
What happens though, when you start trying to cheat on those wing passes, you leave the middle of the floor open for a dive and a lob to a 7'3" Aaron Menzies. Easy finish for him.
Aaron Menzies, another one of those guys. Willie Williams didn't particularly know all that well. Ended up running into LJ Coward down at an NBA camp in Atlanta. And that was how they got connected.
How would you like to just stumble on a 7'3" guy? Yeah, we'll take him.
Yeah, it doesn't always happen that easy.
Yeah, they don't grow on trees, right?
No, sir. Santino DiTrepido with the miss for her bat.
Moving.
And there's Menzies. Well, the Eagles, for those that are too young, are a band that have sold the fourth most albums in the U.S. all time. Only the Beatles, Garth Brooks, and Elvis sold more. Well, they played three sold-out shows at the Fabulous Forum in Inglewood, California back in 2018, and they made a film out of those three incredible nights. The premiere of that film is tonight, 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific on ESPN and the ESPN app. Somewhere, Don Henley wondering, there are folks out there that haven't heard of me?
How is that possible?
Yeah. Taylor contacted an offensive foul, they'll say. Gay Elmore not liking the call.
You know, right here, just got to seal off the drive, and that's exactly what they did. Off of the dribble penetration, Ryan Taylor, not the most fleet of feet, trying to turn that corner. He should have dished. It would have been wise, but the charge taken nicely by Peoria.
Heard that, by the way, at one point in this third quarter was a perfect 7 of 7 on two-point field goals. Don't even need threes at this point.
Brian Taylor.
Allen left it up on the rim.
Traveled. Oh, offensive foul, even worse. He traveled first, though.
And one of those bang-bang collisions. TheTournament.com is your place for all things TBT. Check it out to learn more on the week's matchups and other stories about the basketball tournament. We have another one coming up in the afternoon session. Two more after that with Chris Vosters, Jen, and Dan Dockage. What do you think about the rest of them, Scar? I'm loving our next game.
Our next game is what I'm really looking forward to, Team Hines and Sideline Cancer. A lot of overseas pros on both those teams, a lot of bucket getters.
And the roster composition is a lot different for Team Hines. They ended up making that Final Four semifinal run last year at TBT. But only one player from that team is there, St. Joe's alum Isaiah Miles.
But yet they're still able to get assemble a nice collection of talent. But you're right, they went to the Final Four last year, coached by Juan Dixon, the head coach at Coppin now. And Juan, of course, people probably know Juan more for Housewives of Potomac now. He's on there with his wife, Robin Dixon. But basketball fans know him for national championship at the University of Maryland.
A 14-point lead for Heard That. Game number one of what's a quadruple header, day two of the basketball tournament. The single elimination, what's now 2014 million dollar winner take all tournament.
Here comes the ball screen. Now, if you let them turn this corner, look, they all stay with the dive guy, and they leave the most dangerous guy on the floor. But there's always a microsecond where you have to make a decision defensively, and it's always wrong, no matter what you do. I mean, they got away with it that time, but time and time again, you know, you have to make those decisions, and you have to be on the same page deep on defense, or you're going to get murdered by this Herd team.
And you look at it, everybody but one, in terms of this Heard That rotation, has found the basket today. And they have five different guys that have knocked down a three as Ott Elmore takes a tumble.
Actually, he's pretty fleet of feet, yeah. Right? He didn't even fall.
Yeah, he didn't even fall. He went up over the board. But who would have thought Ott Elmore today, the leading scorer, but Stevie Browning with ice on that ankle. So winning in spite of one of their best shooters not being out there with them. And at one point, one of the Elmores had said during our Puma in the huddle, if we still had Browning, this game would be over.
Yeah. Still over.
Well, a lot going on from now until July 14th with the basketball tournament. Round of 16 gets going in a couple days. Boeheim's Army awaiting the winner of the Purdue alumni, Men of Mackey, and Heartfire, which has a lot of Oklahoma alumni, and a lot of good players. And, of course, overseas elite down at the bottom of that bracket.
How about the teams that are waiting to play, though, in that round of 16? Of course, yep. Everybody, all eight teams got a bye. Bam's Army's reloaded. Challenge ALS, again, that's the team I picked to win it all. But those Golden Eagles, man, they are really good. They got to the final game last year, played a close matchup with Carmen's crew. But, man, there's some really good teams, a lot of good basketball to be played in the coming days on ESPN.
Wide it down this third quarter here of our first game. All heard that. Trayvon Allen keeping his team in. Chance for a four-point play.
Great usage of the ball screen right there. And when you have a 7'3" guy setting that ball screen, it's a little easier to come off clean. I mean, look at that area right there. That is a lot of area. And again, we talked about the window that he needs. Not a lot for Trayvon Allen to cash it in. And the big being that low is what created that shot. If Ryan Taylor doesn't show, and what I mean by show is get a pet behind the three-point line and discourage that shot, otherwise he's going to let it fly.
22 now for Trayvon Allen. But heard that right where they were at the break, pretty much. Well in command, 11-point lead for the guys mostly who played their college basketball in Huntington, West Virginia. With a couple of extra additions, the Elmore family smiling big today here at TBT 2020.
Hey, get a stop, block out and rebound, and get it out and go.
We're down to what is 20 teams that are still alive for TBT 2020. Handed out four bids yesterday, four more coming. Matt Martucci, Tim Scarborough, and the third member of our team is the Pride of New Orleans, Jed Hale.
Matt, some bad news for Heard That. Unfortunately, Marshall Products' Stevie Browning, who now plays in Slovakia, he is done for the day with that right ankle injury. Hopefully, he'll be able to return should they advance to play in further rounds later in the tournament. He is going to stay on the bench and cheer on his teammates. He does not want to be taken back to the locker room.
And if you know, Jed, what we all know about Stevie Browning, that's typical Stevie Browning. Just a tough, hard-nosed competitor.
Even
when it comes to things like cards behind the scenes at TBT. I don't know if you saw that Twitter video of he and John Elmore Scar earlier this week.
I did not.
I think it was the two of them and either Ryan Taylor or Rondale Watson. I can't remember. But Stevie Browning ended up winning, standing up, and said, just keep killing him. Or something to that effect.
Did you edit that for television?
No, I
didn't. Okay.
That was uncensored.
So don't look now. We have an 11-point game. And that when you're thinking about the Elam ending, you want to be within striking distance. If you're Peoria, you can get this thing down to 3 or 4 points. You know, you got a chance once you get in the Elam ending scenario.
Yeah, 9-2 run goes to 12-2. Trayvon Allen.
And they have not been able to handle those ball screens or the pin down screens for Trayvon Allen. He is coming off clean and letting it fly. 25 points, 4 for 7 from downtown.
A top 20 scorer in Division I a year ago.
He's got Ja'Cory Williams. Watch, this time Elmore was able to help.
So now single digits. Nice. And Menzies helping get it to 2 possessions.
How about the flow to the offense, though? What a great adjustment by Peoria. They have stuck with it. They're getting some stops now. And then offensively, they have some nice flow to their game. And heard that has gone a little cold here in the late going.
Well, this hasn't been a single-digit game since the 8-minute mark of the second quarter.
Man, that would have been big if they could have converted that transition opportunity. And then right back at you, Cash Money. 877 Cash now, JT Wentworth.
Just way too much rhythm for John Elmore to miss that shot.
And that is the first knockdown from downtown in the second half for a team that couldn't miss in the first.
Third made three of the afternoon for John Elmore. Though it's taken him 10 attempts to get there, which is a little uncharacteristic. He's only shot 3 of 10 this afternoon.
But isn't he so timely with his buckets? We've seen that so many times. He could sense the moment as good as anybody, which is why he is the all-time leading scorer in Conference USA history.
67 times, 20 or more points. 11 times, 30 or more in John Elmore's career. Watson with the air ball, and Luther able to hit the offensive glass and gets the contact.
Those corner threes is what you get off of that dribble penetration. If you dive, take the dive guy away, take that guy dribbling around the corner away, the skip pass to the corner, to the other corner is where you're gonna get those shots.
And Ryan Luther's winning share sent with Zell. $100,000. That even split among her that. Got familiar with Ryan Luther, did a lot of these guys by playing against him at college. 4 years at Pitt and then did the extra year at Arizona after what was some injury troubles. And back to double digits, up 11, right where we were when we started this quarter.
That was quick. And Peoria blew a real opportunity. Remember, they were down by 6 with the transition opportunity that didn't go. And John Elmore came down at the other end. That's a 5-point swing. I mean, that's big in a scenario like this.
Menzies, nice power move to the basket.
And there's nobody in green that's going to stop that 7-for-3 Menzies when he catches it. Nice, nimble move around the bucket, too.
Not necessarily Chris Coakley's game, but he can hit that.
Oh, no, no, no.
Williams contacted offensive foul.
We lost the shoe.
In the circle. He was outside the circle when the contact occurred.
My question is, can we check to see if his feet were in?
So they were outside the circle. I know one of his shoes was outside the circle because there it is.
Yeah, he got hit in the circle.
So he gets credit for that, right?
Gay Elmore was asking for the review. Our crew today, Anthony Eads, Jamal Rawls, Ryan Sassano. Motion denied. Luke Benlundi out there playing with what's the 5 personal fouls.
Great job by Rondell Watson to be there on the catch, though. He's a really good defensive player, number one for her that.
Yeah, just forced Allen into a bad shot. Elmore again from that same spot. Chased down, and Luther couldn't knock it off of what would have been Lundy.
Why didn't he just throw it to Chris Coakley? He was standing there asking for the ball. He tried to knock it off of Lundy and missed him. So now...
It's easy for us to say from Indianapolis, right, Scar?
It's very true. And basketball is a series of quick decisions, but that was an easy one for me, I think.
Thank you.
But right now, if they can get a bucket here, you start thinking about trying to keep it under 5.
Menzies attacking.
Oh, they need that.
And commits the foul on Ja'Cory Williams.
5:49 to play. Again, we stop the clock under 4 minutes. So roughly a minute and 49 seconds. They're trying to cut this lead before we get into an Elam ending scenario. And that ball just would not go for Aaron Menzies right there. So close.
Aaron Menzies, who was 6 feet, 2 inches tall in the ninth grade, ended up growing 9 inches over the next 3 years. And was a 7-footer by the time he hit his senior year of high school.
That's gotta be life-changing for a lot of reasons, right? Not the least of which is your wardrobe.
He said in the ninth grade, there was he and one of his classmates, they were both 6'2", and then I think he left him in his tracks.
I say so.
After that 3-year growth spurt. Allen.
Nice split.
And trip to the foul line coming.
Great job, gents.
For Trayvon Allen.
Yes, it was. That was 32.
We're all right.
22. Heard that foul call number 22,
Ja'Cory. Ja'Cory Williams hit with the personal. As we get a look at Willie Williams, the GM of the Peoria All-Stars.
He's not giving up either.
Hey, my man.
Team of time.
Okay, stop.
Team
stop.
Scar that's playing in honor of former Peoria great Howard Nathan. He played his college basketball at DePaul, passed away a year ago. Was actually supposed to coach at TBT a year ago, but right around this time, ended up in the hospital for what was 3 weeks last July and passed away in his late 40s.
Coach Williams said that's the guy he kind of looked up to growing up as a basketball player.
Get it, Rondo.
Down to an 8-point game. Coakley trying to extend it and can't. As we approach Elam ending time, first dead ball at 4 minutes or inside.
Oh.
And we'll set the leading team's target score.
Another good defensive play by Rondell Watson.
And going to the lane and finding the bucket.
Rondell Watson. You've seen Coming to America, right? Randy Watson?
Yes, sir.
Remember the band name, right? Can we say it?
Menzies grabs the board.
So 4:31. So now you try to get a quick one and hope Marshall takes a shot. Hope that heard that takes a quick one, but they probably won't. But you want to make sure you score here if you're Peoria. That's not a good look.
One and done for Kendall Davis.
Yeah, so if you heard that, they're not used to slowing it down. We talked about their pace of play. And right there, see, if I'm them, I'm pulling that out, getting it under 4 minutes, and then going in to the Elam ending.
Well, Luther just saved a bucket with a great block on Lundy.
See, right here, you should pull this out. Oh, he trapped.
Williams, I don't know how they didn't call that.
We're not in Orlando yet, are we?
That's true.
We got the possession.
Wow.
12-point Hurd lead, Tim Scarborough.
Well, it wasn't the best time management, but Hurd that only knows one pace, and that is full go. And as a result, they're up 72-61. The defense at the other end by Ryan, and then the run out at the other end, and take a run, too. Oh, you know what? They may not have been traveling. Great job by Ja'Cory Williams.
Scar, you keep calling Luther Ryan. Ryan Luther. Yeah, you've been calling him by his first
name. Yeah, I know. I know his first name is Ryan. I couldn't remember his last
name. Yeah, no, I know. That's why.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You touch
the ball in the wing.
But
look at
trying
to get an angle way to make the post pass and make the corner pass.
Hey,
you're
kind of
too tight to make the post pass.
What we can do is, we can do though, we can go ahead and have him be the first.
He's not in. KB in.
KB could be the first trainer. Yeah, he can be the first guy. And what we could do is we could come off here because you know they're going to try to switch that and slip that guy. Or you go opposite side and just slip it.
We're going to get Smith.
The ball in the wing, look, is going to be at an angle where you can make the post pass and make the corner pass.
Hey,
you're kind of
too tight to make the post pass.
What we can do is, we can do though, we can go ahead and have him be the first.
He not in. KB in.
KB could be the first screener.
KB
could be the first screener.
And you know, it's a lot of strategy that goes into the Elam ending, but they missed their window. The window was trying to get this lead down to single digits before you get into the Elam ending scenario. Now it's about possession by possession. And if you're hurt, if you're heard that, you're not really caring if they score that much because you're just trying to get 8 points and end this thing.
Well, that was In the Huddle presented by Puma. Here at the basketball tournament, it's Elam ending time. 12-point lead for Heard That. Now, what exactly is the Elam ending? How it occurs either at the 4-minute mark or under the first dead ball. You take the leading team score, you add 8 points, you set a target score. First team to get there wins. And in this case, it's 80 points.
So Peoria needs 20 points, which is a tough hill when you consider, and you heard that only needs 8 points. Need a lot of stops right now.
And let's look at some of them. CJ Jackson yesterday, which was game one of four as part of the quadruple header. And we said, if your name was CJ, you had a great 4th of July.
CJ Harris with a run out to end the game, two hands with authority. And that ended the day for TBT as well. What a great way to end a phenomenal day of basketball on the 4th of July. Fireworks, right?
Absolutely. Stuck the landing there too. Rondale Watson had heard that, hoping to move on where they would play the money team. Afternoon matinee on Thursday, as we're into day two of technically what is 11. There is one off day, but yeah, we go until July 14th.
The TBT. Teams, those top eight teams they got to buy, they have to be just so ready to play basketball right now, especially watching this at home, well not at home, in the bubble.
Six to shoot for the Peoria All-Stars. Coward rising up. And John Elmore clearing the rebound for Heard That.
So again, if you're the team with the big lead, you just want to run good offense, get your buckets and get out of here, because the longer you give the open door to the team that's trailing, the more likely they are to make a comeback. And if they get the game close, then the pressure becomes on you. Heard That
foul. Coming up tonight at 11 Eastern, 8 Pacific, it's the final Sports Center of the day on ESPN and the ESPN app. Hey, you would think there's a lot of TBT talk.
Yeah, not a lot of basketball going on besides this, right?
Yeah, what else are you breaking down at this point?
Oh, no, that cornhole has been kind of on ESPN a lot. I don't know how you break that down, though.
Nothing like the 4th of July yesterday. We had the hot dog eating contest, cornhole, and then TBT. Not necessarily in that order of importance.
Oh, nice cross.
Smith able to rescue that. Nice find for Williams using the rim, but couldn't convert the reverse.
And if he just used his right hand like that, he would have had an uncontested layup.
Elmore breaking up the possession here. That's John Elmore.
So the winner of this plays TMT, the money team, Floyd Mayweather's entry into the TBT. basically, though, that team is made up of Jimmer Fredette's team from a couple years ago.
And there's quite a bit of talent, as there is on a lot of these TBT teams. All of them, but that's one of the ones that stands out. They were able to get Tony Roten to come play.
We had their coach David Nurse on earlier with us via Zoom. How about Zoom? You should have got stock in that back in March, huh?
Yeah, it's like the Marty McFly almanac from Back to the Future.
Yeah, exactly.
Williams gets them closer.
They need to get on the phone with Teddy Riley. All I want to do is I'm a zoom, 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 and a boom, boom.
I heard that certainly shaking the room this afternoon.
Giggity, yep.
20 and 21 minutes now for Ja'Cory Williams. And 6 points away toward a round of 16 matchup with the money team.
And it's got to be daunting when you look at that target score of 80 and you're still at 60. But you really can't approach it that way. You have to approach it in terms of like you're playing pickup ball. We need to stop. We need a bucket. We need to stop. We need another bucket.
Let's go in the huddle again, presented by Puma.
They penetrate your man, help you die. All right? Let's spread them out and let's attack downhill, man. All right? When first come out, let's try that. What's going to hurt? Let's try it. All right.
So we are switching everything. Okay, so to be big, yeah. You got to be out on the ball. And then take the nearest corner, switch that back out. Together on three, one, two, three.
Yeah.
Head coach Jim Young, mid Willie Williams, and the Peoria All-Stars.
Five.
Jen Hale told you before. Assembled on basically the last couple weeks' notice by one of Peoria's favorite sons. You see him, Willie Williams, right there. They had been in the Jamboree in Philadelphia back in 2017.
Yeah, that was the first year TBT experimented with the Elam ending. Only during the Jamboree, though. They didn't do it for the rest of the tournament.
And Willie Williams said, I felt fortunate that we were able to get to experience that.
Yeah.
To tell these guys what to expect. Koch Barr back in.
Now they're going zone. They've been playing kind of a matchup earlier, too, but that was a true zone there.
Kendall Davis with the air ball. Elmore creating his own shot, but having to go over the 7-footer Barr. Allen,
oh,
and Barr saving it. And good heads up play off of Elmore's sneaker.
When you think about the fine line between winning and losing at times, there's 6 to 8 points that Peoria should have on the board. That's another 2 points that they should have had. It's just a clean catch gets you a layup. They missed a few dunks in the first half. You think about all those points, and this is where you are.
Allen drew in the double. Travel. Zach Charles shuffling his feet.
Shuffling. Yeah. Man.
So turnover for Peoria All-Stars. Now their 13th. And we'll hand out another bid here to get the field down to 19. And then still three more to come. Sideline Cancer Team Hines, a bunch of TBT veterans on the Sideline Cancer side. The men of Mackey, the Purdue alumni against Heartfire. And the Clemson alumni, Power of the Paw, against another really experienced team in Armored Athlete.
Armored Athlete is a longtime team in TBT as well.
Rondale Watson getting heard that to 4 points away. Charles getting a good look.
It's his first bucket of the afternoon. He was 0 for 7 prior to that.
And he was another interesting connection, Zach Charles. Jim Youngman's son, AJ, plays at Eastern Kentucky, was taking a redshirt year, knew Zach Charles from down there. He finished up, he ended up on the Peoria roster. 13-point lead, heard that, 4 away from moving on. Try to see, I'm falling behind. What could be? Oh, bring me up higher.
Hey. Finish this thing and let's go party. Here. Finish this thing and let's party. You all right? Hell of a pass.
Now back at Columbus, 13-point lead for Hurt then. Day two of the round of 24, TBT 2020 edition. Normally 64 teams, but held a fully quarantined tournament in the middle of this COVID-19 pandemic. So field cut down to 24. We've handed out already four bids into the round of 16. We'll get four more today, the first of which is right now. And heard that, Tim Scarborough, 4 points away.
What a remarkable undertaking, though, by TBT to be able to do this.
Now, the half of the bracket that we already decided, Carmen's Crew, the defending champs, they match up with House of Pain, Red Scare, the Dayton alumni.
Can't wait for that one.
Yeah, an interesting Ohio matchup with Big X. A lot of former Ohio State guys there, too. And then Golden Eagles, the Team CP3, who had to come back with the Elam-ending win last night. And the 5-12 game.
Picking the upset right there, baby.
Yep.
Just like the NCAAs, too. 12-5 matchup, dangerous. Brotherly love, the team out of Philadelphia. Very good team. We saw them yesterday. Cohesive, those Temple guards, Moore and Khalif Wyatt. Man, really good team.
And how many tweets did we see yesterday about Khalif Wyatt? Classic Khalif Wyatt.
Yeah, man, people in Philadelphia and really all over the country know what Khalif can do.
Heard that, wanted the lob to John Elmore. And they use Smith, somebody's open, it's Williams. And going to the line.
One shot, everybody bell. One shot in the ball.
So now they just get one shot in the ball. As the team with the lead and close enough to the target score, instead of getting two shots, they'll just get one and the basketball. So really it's imperative as the trailing team that you don't foul late game in an Elam ending scenario. So they shouldn't give them two. I think you got to be within one possession, right?
Yep.
And it's still 4 points. It's a little tweak to the Elam ending, ever evolving.
Near double-double this afternoon for Ja'Cory Williams.
How about those banners in the corner, man? What a great job TBT has done setting up the look of the floor. You wouldn't know. You don't even think about the fact that they're playing in front of no one, basically. Other than the 197 countries that are watching, of course, but not in person.
2 points away now, heard that. You see some of the champion banners that were behind the basket support, the four straight for Overseas Elite. Carmen's Crew winning a year ago. Will it be a successful title defense? We get to find out, at least the start of that this week. Knocked out of bounds, and it'll stay with Trayvon Allen and this Peoria All-Stars team.
These guys are pretty good at jumping over those sponsor boards, aren't they? No one's knocked them down.
At least the court isn't raised like...
Oh, like at the NCAA tournament?
Yeah. I always would worry about that.
Yeah, me too. Of course, I never had to worry about finishing in the Final Four playing at Liberty.
Well, even if you made it during your era, they weren't doing that then,
yeah,
right?
That's very true. And then you're showing my age there, too.
Sorry, buddy.
You're acting like I was playing on peach baskets. You know, we weren't pushing that ladder out there, getting the ball out of the rim.
You and I have worked together long enough where I could do that to you.
Yeah, you could do that. I'll get you back, though, right?
I know you will. Luke Monlundy, maybe too little too late for the Peoria All-Stars.
Yeah, just his 7 point, 2 for 8 from the field. And Allen is now 10 for 20.
And why not go up top to Smith? Mr. Elevator Man.
Yeah, he was the dunker, and he's also the Elam Ender.
Well, a lot more ups than downs today for her that 80 up on the board and a 15-point win over the Peoria All-Stars to set up the matchup with the money team later this week.
It's a fun first round for her that, but man, do they have their work cut out for them going into the next round. And take a look at this kid right here, Smith, going up and above the call of duty. Great pass once again by John Elmore. What a way to finish a game, right?
I lost count, but I'm pretty sure that was four for Zach Smith.
I know there was three at least. Mount to get Zach Smith to just jump up there and put the card up, right? And this is great, a TBT tradition where you get to advance your teams on the bracket.
Yeah, you take the placard, put it up there. CJ Harris had the best one so far for Team CP3 last night. He put it up and then it fell down. Odd Elmore, though, doing the honors for Heard That. Now, Tim Scarborough, Jen Hale, and I are back with postgame. Heard That, the 15-point win here at TBT.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
15-point win for Heard That to move on to the round of 16, where our player of the game brought to you by FanDuel. Enter fantasy TBT contests and compete for real cash payouts all tournament long. And Jen Hale standing by with our FanDuel player of the game.
Indeed, Matt, we've got Ja'Cory Williams, the player of the game, the man of the hour. Ja'Cory, Heard That seemed in control of this game since the get-go, since the tip. How did it feel out there to y'all as a team?
It felt good. We've been practicing for like 3 weeks now. So we've been together for almost a month. We've been doing a lot of stuff together, out to eat, just building team chemistry. And I think that showed on the court, because we've been together for a month now. So kind of a little bit of an advantage compared to other teams that are just now getting together. And I feel like, you know, we're building some special chemistry right here.
Your opponent was joking a little bit about the age of some of the Heard That members. They thought perhaps they could use that against you. But your depth really seems to be a strength for you.
Oh, yeah. I think we're stronger as a team when we come off the bench. We got a lot of shooters in that starting lineup, and that's how Marshall plays. They get up and down, shoot a lot of threes. But I think we're more physical. We rebound better when we go to the bench.
Up next, you've got the money team. How do you prepare for them?
I mean, obviously, they got a lot of talent. You know, on paper, they're probably one of the best teams in the tournament, but we're going to approach the game the same way. We got depth, and we're not scared of nobody. We're here to play.
We're also glad that basketball is back. What is it like, though, playing with no fans in the stands?
I mean, we kind of created some energy over here on the bench. I don't know if anybody was paying attention, but every time a three went in, we had our own energy. So I think that's big. Just create your own energy. You won't have to worry about no fans.
No fans, no worries.
No problems.
Congratulations on the win, and we look forward to seeing you versus the money team coming up.
Thank you. Thank you.
Matt.
Best motivating factor, they get to stick around. And one of the points that Ja'Cory Williams ended up making, these guys got together 3 weeks ago. They ended up putting up everybody at the famous Greenbrier Hotel down in West Virginia. They paid for the rooms. They paid for preliminary COVID tests. They got their food delivered. They basically made their own bubble, pretty much, Scar, before this even started, which is a really unique approach. They said John Elmore had the best point. We didn't want to take any chances. We wanted to make sure that we ended up sticking around.
Well, it was great that they got the opponent that they got, but again, the trophy right that there, they probably won't get their names on it. This is a very good team, but they're not good enough to win this whole thing. But what a great tournament. When you think about getting your name on that trophy, that's got to be just a tremendous feeling to first win that money, but then secondly, to cement your legacy and what is growing into one of the best things in basketball in terms of watching on TV and participating.
And now we're down to 19 left. It sets up that money team and heard that matchup Thursday afternoon matinee. Overseas Elite gets the winner of that Armored Athlete at Power of the Paw. MLS, who I know Scar likes, is his favorite.